Hi, my name is Charles Bedard Porter. I work on the professional services team at Hootsuite, and today I'm going to walk you through setting up your Hootsuite account and posting messages and how to interact with your audience. So first off, we're going to create a Hootsuite free account. So I'm just going to go to hootsuite.com, go to the sign up button, click on that, and I'm going to set up with a free account today. Here, I want to put my name in. I want to put in my business email. And I want to create a password that I'll remember. Then I click on Create My Free Account. So the first step when you create a new Hootsuite account is to connect your social profiles. So you can either connect them now or you can choose to do this at a later date. From here, I'll just have to select my business, so Hoot Hotel. And click on Done. I'm going to go ahead and connect my other social networks later on. Now I'm going to write in my company name. Now that I've added my social networks, I put in my company name and I've created my Hootsuite account. You can follow through the published content or monitor guide if you'd like to, but today I'm going to explore on my own. There is a wise guide that you can use in the bottom right-hand corner for some more tips and tricks on how to use your Hootsuite account. I'm going to exit for now and maybe come back later. First things first, we're going to want to make sure we have our social networks connected. So just go up to the top left-hand side here and click on Add Social Network. From here, select the social networks that you want to connect, whether it's Twitter, Facebook, Google+, LinkedIn, Instagram, YouTube, or WordPress. Tap on Connect Twitter. Put in your Twitter handle and type in your password and authorize the app. Great. If you ever want to see what social networks you do have connected, just go up to the top left here and hover over the compose box, and this will show you your social networks. There's three key sections to the dashboard. The first is the compose message box. Hovering over top of it will expand it, allowing you to select your social networks and begin composing a message. The other section is what we're seeing in the middle of our screen. This is where we can create different streams for our social networks and be able to interact and engage with our audiences. The third section is the navigation menu on the left-hand side. This helps you navigate to the other parts of the Hootsuite dashboard, allowing you to look at things like analytics, scheduled content, and install any of the apps that you'd like to get to. Let's go ahead and compose our message. I'm going to select my Facebook page, type out my message, and include a link. To include a link, just find the link that you want to use. So for this example, I'll go to the Hootsuite blog. Grab one of the articles that's of interest to me. Copy that URL and bring it back to my compose box and put it in the section that says add a link and shrink it. It's important to shrink your links because it saves your character space when we're looking at Facebook and Twitter. Here I can see my link preview. I can see different photos from the website that I'm pulling from, as well as be able to change the text in the description of the link. This is what people will see when they go to my Facebook page and want to click on the links that I've shared. I can also do other things. I can add image media if I'd like to. So adding an image or a video, just click on Choose Files to Upload, and you can select photos from your computer. Now that I've selected a photo, I could go ahead and even schedule my message. Scheduling a message lets it go out at a later time. There's two ways to schedule your message. One with the auto scheduler, which will pick a time for your post to have the most optimal impact. This will automatically schedule a message for a time of day that you don't have any messages currently scheduled that is the most optimal. If you'd like to manually schedule your messages for a specific time and date, maybe you have a news release or an event coming up, go ahead and use the calendar here and select the day you would like to post to. You can also select the time of day. So let's say next Thursday at 10 a.m. Now I can schedule this message to go out next Thursday at 10 a.m. with the photo I've selected, as well as the link. by clicking on the schedule. If you'd ever like to, you can click on the save and save a draft. Drafts are a great way to start working and composing a message and come back to it later if you need to. Let's go ahead and schedule it. I'm going to see a little pop-up here that says my message has been scheduled. If you ever need to review your scheduled messages, make any edits or changes to them, go to the left-hand navigation bar and click on Publisher. Here, you'll see your scheduled messages. I can see the message I just wrote, and I can go to the far right and click on the pencil icon to edit it. This allows me to change the text, maybe change it to what social network it's going out to, change the photo, put the photo in a different photo album, or any other change that I would like to make to it. You can also go ahead and delete that message if you decide that you do not want it to go out. At the top here, you can filter for the social networks that you want to look at. If I only wanted to see what was going out on my Twitter handle, I could click on just Twitter and see what's coming out for Twitter. On the left-hand side, you can also see your previously scheduled content. By clicking on past scheduled, I'd be able to see what I've scheduled in the last few weeks or months. Let's head over to Streams and start engaging with our audience. You have the option of creating your tabs and streams based off of templates that Hootsuite's generated for you, or starting from scratch. Today, we're going to do it ourselves. So I'm going to click on Browse All Streams. Now that I've done that, I can see that I've created a tab. I'm going to click where it says New Tab and call this my Home Tab. You can create multiple different tabs, up to 20, and each tab can represent a different social network or a different keyword search or however you want to organize your dashboard. Once I've created my tab, I'm going to get a big white box here that allows me to add a stream. At the top, I can select what type of stream I'd like to create. Is it for Twitter, Facebook, or for Instagram? And down here, I can select what is that stream for that social network. If I want to see my mentions, I can click on mentions. If I wanted to see my private inbox or my outbox, I can see those as well. I can see who's following me. I can see any Twitter lists that I've created. I can even see things like my tweets and see what I've been tweeting about and seeing if people are interacting with them or replying to them. One of the fun things about Twitter is you can also create a search. By creating a search, I can actually put in any hashtag, keyword, or set of hashtags and keywords to see what the conversation about those words is. Here, Hootsuite gives you a little preview on what are some of the top trending hashtags at the moment. But let's go ahead and look at anything that has the word hashtag Hootsuite in it. Click on search. And now I can see anyone on Twitter who's using the hashtag Hootsuite in any of their tweets that they're sending out. You can scroll through these streams and see all the photos, the videos, and click into any of them and read more information if you'd like to. If at any time I'd like to go ahead and click on one of the users, I can get a little bit more information about who that particular individual is. Here I can see this person has 71 followers. Here's their description, and I can see if they're following me or not. I can also block or report them if I find that they're breaking the terms of service. I can follow them myself. I can send them a private message, or I can even reply to them if I'd like to. At the top, you can also see what they've been posting about. Other types of interactions that I can do within a stream are directly replying to people. If I click on the reply button, I'm able to compose a message on Twitter and reply to this individual. And hit send. Other interactions that you can do are things like retweets, likes, and even assignments if you're part of an enterprise package. Liking a post, just tap on it. Same thing with retweeting. You'll notice that there's numbers being created, so I know that I've already liked it or I've already retweeted this post. You can also create streams for other social networks. If I wanted to create a Facebook stream, I would just select my Facebook page here. Maybe I want to look at my timeline, maybe I want to look at my private messages, or I want to see any recent activity that's happened on my Facebook page. Within Facebook, you have the same functionalities. You can click on users, You can like their comments. You can reply to their comments. You can share any posts that you find on Facebook. And if you're part of enterprise, you can also assign. So let's reply to Jenna. The final stream that we can look at today is Instagram. Tapping on Instagram allows me to go ahead and look up for particular users, my posts and the engagements that are happening on my posts, or look up a hashtag or even a location. Let's go ahead and look up Hootsuite. Here I can see all the people who are using the hashtag Hootsuite on Instagram and the photos that they've attached. I can scroll through them, I can like, leave comments, or even reshare them on my own Instagram handle if I would like to. You can also read the comments. As I mentioned before, you can create multiple tabs and have multiple different streams within those tabs. Organizing your Hootsuite dashboard is key to having great success with it, but also a great way for you to stay organized and on top of your social game. All right, let's look at how you can get more resources and information on Hootsuite and manage your Hootsuite profile settings. Go over to the left-hand side, scroll down to the bottom, and you'll see the help section. This is a great way for you to get information or help on your Hootsuite account. If you run into any issues around posting or interacting with people or anything to do with your social networks or Hootsuite dashboard, contact our help desk and they'll get back to you as fast as they can. You can also tweet at us for support if you'd like to practice your Twitter game. Under the tools section, you have access to our education platforms. Hootsuite offers a variety of online education platforms that you can access and watch videos and read articles about social media best practices and get information that way. We also have the mobile app, so if you're on iOS or Android and you want to use Hootsuite on the go, you can download our app straight from the app stores. Finally, you do have your account settings. Clicking on this will allow you to modify things like your name, upload a photo into your Hootsuite account, make sure you have the right description, company name, and most importantly, make sure you're in the right time zone. Under preferences, you can change your language if you'd like to. If you prefer to work in another language outside of English, you can select from the variety of different languages that we support. All right, thank you very much for attending this walkthrough. Once again, my name is Charles, and hope you learned a little bit about Hootsuite today. And feel free to reach out to us if you do have any questions. Thank you. Bye-bye.